While the world watches Tesla, Toyota, and CATL make headlines, Hyundai has been building in silence, something that could shake the global EV market to its core. But here's the real shocker. They might be the first major car manufacturer to actually bring solid-state batteries to commercial electric vehicles. How did a company known for reliable mid-range sedans suddenly become the dark horse in one of the biggest technological races of our time? Let's dive deep into what Hyundai has been doing behind the scenes, and why their move could change how we drive, how we charge, and even how we fly. Earlier this year, Hyundai made a quiet announcement that took even the most die-hard EV enthusiasts by surprise. They revealed plans to begin pilot production of solid-state batteries by the end of this year, with the intention to integrate them into actual EVs for real-world testing starting January 2025. This might seem sudden, but it's the result of years of stealthy R&D. While companies like Toyota, Nissan, and Honda have been shouting from rooftops about solid-state breakthroughs since the early 2010s, Hyundai has taken a different route. Silence. Think about this. Toyota announced it had pilot-ready solid-state batteries in 2015. In 2018, they promised EVs using the technology. Yet here we are, in late 2024, and there's still no commercial, solid-state Toyota EV. Meanwhile, Hyundai said nothing, yet they might just be first to actually deliver. So what makes solid-state batteries such a big deal? What are solid-state batteries, and why do they matter? Solid-state batteries don't just represent a step forward, they represent a potential leap in energy storage. Unlike traditional lithium-ion batteries, which use liquid electrolytes, solid-state batteries use solid materials to move ions between the cathode and anode. This seemingly small difference brings with it massive advantages. Higher energy density. Solid-state batteries can store much more energy in the same amount of space. That means EVs can have much longer range. Some estimates say up to double the range of current EVs. Faster charging. Because of the chemistry involved, solid-state batteries can charge faster than lithium-ion batteries without overheating or degrading. Improved safety. One of the biggest problems with current EV batteries is the risk of fire or explosion due to the flammable liquid inside. Solid-state batteries eliminate that liquid, which greatly reduces the fire risk. Longer lifespan. These batteries don't degrade as quickly as current batteries, meaning you won't have to replace them nearly as often. In short, solid-state batteries are safer, longer-lasting, more powerful, and faster charging. They're what everyone in the industry has been chasing for over a decade. And now, Hyundai says they have it ready. If Hyundai succeeds in mass-producing this technology, the result could be an electric vehicle with over 1,000 kilometers, 620 miles of range, charging in minutes, with almost no safety risk. That's not a better EV. That's a completely new kind of transportation. Hyundai's research and pilot production facility. At the heart of this plan is Hyundai's Wiwang Research Institute in South Korea. It houses their next-generation battery R&D center, where installation of production equipment is already nearing completion. According to official reports, all that remains is the implementation of logistics automation. Once that's done, low-scale production begins early 2025. These early batteries will be used in Hyundai EVs undergoing testing in real-world conditions. The roadmap is clear. 2025, small-scale testing in high-end EVs. 2027, limited rollout in premium models. 2030, full mass production across multiple segments. But what happens in those 5 years between now and 2030? Don't expect solid-state batteries in every Hyundai EV just yet. Instead, Hyundai is likely to reserve them for high-end models at first. These vehicles will likely offer longer range, up to 1,000 kilometers, ultra-fast charging, better performance in extreme climates. Imagine a luxury electric SUV that charges faster than your phone and drives from one state to another and halfway back on a single charge. That's the level we're talking about. Still, it's important to note, mass production of solid-state batteries is incredibly difficult. The manufacturing process is expensive and extremely sensitive to contamination. Which brings us to the next question. Can Hyundai really pull this off before its competitors? Toyota has been the loudest voice in the room when it comes to solid-state claims. But despite all the noise, they haven't delivered yet. their last major promise placed solid-state EVs in the second half of the 2020s. Nissan and Honda have made similar announcements. In fact, Honda also revealed their own demo production line set to go operational in 2025. But the second half of the 2020s is vague. That could be 2026 or 2030. Compare that to Hyundai, which not only gave specific timelines but is almost done setting up its pilot line. Some assumed Hyundai was using Samsung's solid-state tech. After all, Samsung SDI has been testing solid-state batteries with other manufacturers already. But no, Hyundai is developing its own technology, meaning they won't have to rely on external suppliers. However, Samsung's batteries are still a strong contender. They're actively being tested by other EV makers and could be widely available soon. So if you're a car maker without solid-state R&D, Samsung could become your go-to supplier. But for Hyundai, the decision to build in-house means more control, more innovation, and more profit. This is where it gets complicated. CATL, the Chinese battery giant, is already shipping condensed batteries with 500 Wh/kg energy density, more than most current EV batteries and even rivaling projected solid-state specs. And they're already on the market. Geely, the company behind Zeekr, also has its Golden Brick battery, arguably the best LFP battery in the world. It offers charging at 600 kilowatt, energy density of 250 Wh/kg, unmatched for LFP, charging times under 10 minutes. So the question is, will solid-state batteries arrive too late to compete? If traditional batteries become nearly as good and cheaper, the industry may adopt a hybrid strategy. This tech isn't just for cars anymore. Earlier this year, a Chinese company named Ehang conducted the world's first pilotless passenger-carrying eVTOL test flight powered by solid-state batteries. And CATL released a video of a commercial aircraft powered by their condensed battery. With an energy density of 500 Wh/kg, long-distance electric air travel is no longer science fiction. Solid-state batteries could revolutionize aviation, too, replacing jet fuel and cutting emissions massively. What comes next? Battery technology is improving at a rate we've never seen before. Charging speeds are rising, prices are falling, energy density is growing, AI-driven battery research is accelerating everything. And as we approach 2030, experts like Tony Seba and Christopher Mann predict 90-95% EV adoption worldwide. Imagine explaining today's EVs to someone in 2034. We'll say things like, "Remember when 10-minute charging was impressive? Remember when EVs only went 300 miles on a charge?" The future is coming faster than we think. Hyundai's move into solid state isn't just bold, it's strategic. By investing early in pilot production and developing in-house technology, they're positioning themselves as a leader. But they're not alone. Competition from CATL, Samsung, Geely, and others is intense. Still, it's clear, the battery wars are heating up. Whether Hyundai wins the race or not, one thing is undeniable. The EV revolution is no longer about if, it's about how soon. What do you think? Can Hyundai deliver on its promise? Will solid-state batteries take over? Or will high-performance lithium-based alternatives win the race? Let us know in the comments. And one more thing to know. The age of combustion is ending, the age of electrification, it's just getting started.